Good evening, everyone. I'm accompanied by Dr. Angelica today, CEO of AI Directions, and we will be discussing the impacts of coronavirus today. Thank you very much for joining.
Thank you.
Pleasure to be with you.
Very nice to meet you.
So, Dr. Angelica, we're going to be diving directly to the questions,
please,
if you may. How do you feel about this coronavirus at the moment?
Yeah.
How's the impacts been like for you?
I feel still nowadays as scared. And I try to keep with all the COVID-19 measures because it is a very bad threat. And us humans are definitely challenged by that. Mm. For us, from AI Directions, we use the quiet time to just enhance and further develop AI solutions based on our existing developments. Mm-hmm. Particularly to help that situation.
Excellent. Yes, you did mention that previously when we were speaking, having a conversation. And I want to drive into that question and understand there's a lot happening within the AI industry and in the health industry specifically. Could you explain further on the impacts of the AI directions within this path as well?
Yeah. Our impacts with COVID-19 were, so to speak, positive and negative. Mm-hmm. Let me start with the not so pleasant side. What happened is at the beginning of the year, we had some interesting projects and we had some interesting, what we call proof of concept, where we show to customers how our solutions work. And that looked all very promising. Mm-hmm. And then from one day to the other, yeah, killed. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, none of this had made it back yet. And all still of the same reason, because of COVID-19. Mm-hmm. So that is the downside of things. A pity. Yet, on the other hand, as I said, we used the time that was given to us, particularly but not only during the lockdown, to take our existing capabilities in computer vision, mm-hmm, and expand the solution to help to come up with solutions that, in order to support the compliance with the COVID-19 controls and measures, that helps to measure whether people wear masks, so we can do that. So we would now raise an alarm in that software. Mm-hmm. And also whether people maintain social distance. So, about 2 meters, so that might just about pass.
Right. Obviously, the AI industry itself is playing a huge role in the healthcare systems, as you just explained. Do you think there is more that could be done within the AI perspective towards the health industry?
There's always more things to be done. Yeah. From our perspective, what's most important is that people realize that because almost half of the infections with COVID-19, mm-hmm, come from those people that don't yet show symptoms. Mm-hmm. So these poor people themselves, they don't know that they have it. Mm-hmm. Therefore, they easily might give it further without even knowing what they're doing. And the only thing that helps against that is, even though it's boring and nobody likes it, but wearing masks and keeping social distance. And this is the reason why we developed these solutions, to help people in all public places like malls or schools or universities or airports, whatever you want, just to make sure that we reduce the number of infections.
Absolutely right, absolutely. But however, coming back to the topic, there is a lot of ambiguity or uncertainty. How do you cope with the current situations of this uncertainty?
Yeah, we took a multi-tier approach. So what we did is we developed the COVID-19 measures, mm-hmm, with support, which I just mentioned to you. But that was not the only thing. We looked at our whole portfolio and thought, how can we expand, mm-hmm, and what can we do in order to see what else people need. And it went into many, many directions. I don't want to go through all of them now. Just to give you one example, an interesting new development is predictive maintenance, which is one of the hot topics. And predictive maintenance is using AI to actually tell that a piece of equipment will fail before it fails. Oh. And so you avoid not only the repair, but also the costly impacts of the failure. Mm-hmm.
Interesting. So you're taking pre-measures in order
exactly.
to predict it, which is great. Now, coming to the fact, back to the country that we are all staying in, how do you think UAE has reacted to the current situation of the COVID, and how do you think we could have done better?
I think that UAE acted particularly well. What I like is, yes, they are relatively strict on the measures, and that appears to be a far better way than being too lenient, because case numbers are supposed to go down, and as long as people are maintaining the measures, they will go down, and we all know, well, people are people, so they will not all comply happily, and some even protest against it. Having this double-sided approach in one way, yes, to open things up. Mm-hmm. No country can afford more and more lockdowns, and it's pretty ruinous. So opening things up, let people do their business, but at the same time checking that they do comply with the measures, which are apparently at this point in time the best we know.
Exactly right. And you know, we're all working towards flattening the curve as well.
Why we developed these solutions, because yes, we do want to flatten the curve.
Exactly right. Now fast forward to few months forward, when COVID is over, how long it will take,
inshallah.
We don't really know. But getting into that point, where do you think AI would sit on a country's perspective? And where do you think it will be positioned then?
That is a very interesting question, because there are different elements that come to play here. Mm-hmm. First of all, COVID has changed our way of working and our way of living. So retail is a wonderful example. Retail is forced to go more and more online. Mm-hmm. That alone requires some AI to manage that situation. All organizations have to work more effectively, more economically, and again, AI can help to support that. So what we've seen, yes, the changes that happen to all our lives, all our work, is supporting in general digitization, artificial intelligence, managing these situations. On the other hand, we have seen quite drastic economic impacts. Mm-hmm. None of these things come for free. So therefore, more than ever, organizations should have an AI strategy that helps them to make the right decision where to invest and where not. Because with artificial intelligence, that's something we have been saying since day one, and we are still believing, the early adopters will still be the long-term winners. And of course, we would like organizations to be in that role.
Exactly right. No, thank you very much for those wise words. One final question is, what have you learned from this pandemic, the AI erections, and as Dr. Angelica yourself?
Yeah, personally, first of all, I have learned nothing is sure in this world, and learn to expect the unexpected. Just be prepared. When I think a bit further of humans and what they should do, we should, from one point of view, definitely avoid further zoonotic diseases. Mm-hmm. And what to do for that is relatively simple. You just need to separate the nice wild animals from the nice humans, and then the problem is less. Whether it's done is a secondary question. But there might also be, what is the likelihood that the next pandemic will again be a zoonotic disease? Mm-hmm. Not too high from my point of view. It can happen, yeah, but more likely it's something related to climate, water, etc. That is a potential wobbler that is soon to come. Another possibility is, for example, when you look into the cybersecurity world, if you have, because we are all so dependent on computers, and COVID-19 has made this dependency stronger. If there is a nice attack that takes out just a quarter of all what we're using, the world would be a very different place. So what I think what we all should do is to plan for and fight this together, not so much individually.
Absolutely right, absolutely right. Dr. Njeka, thank you very much for your time. I think we have touched on very important topics today. And thanks again for your time and the answers you gave us.
My pleasure. It was a real pleasure to be here and speak to you.
We must be able to react faster and more flexible. With a still further growing together worldwide, we can always come to such surprises.